Welcome to the short video session on important features introduced with latest ABB PCM600 version 2.13. During the session today, we will have a quick recap on some of the functionalities brought out with previous PCM600 version, PCM600 2.12 as well. Hello, my name is Gaurav Srivastava, Product Manager for ABB PCM600. Here are my contact details. I encourage you to connect for any questions, queries, or suggestions, etc. Before getting into the details of PCM600 2.13 and 2.12, let's have a quick recap on PCM600 itself, especially for our new users here. So PCM600 is a free to download and use tool to configure and manage ABB protection and control IDs. PCM600 enables customers to access the whole ABB Reliant protection and control ID portfolio with the same ID configuration tool. So with PCM600, you get same tool for all ABB Reliant IDs, and then it's the same tool which is useful for the entire life cycle of the ID. So it means from engineering, commissioning, operations and maintenance of the ID. Next is, where can you get PCM600 from, or where can you download PCM600 from? So PCM600 is free to download. The link is here on the screen, or you can find it also on the product page of PCM600. Important to note is that you need to register before you can download PCM600. Let's have a quick look on the new features, couple of important features that are introduced with PCM600 version 2.13. Now, these are besides the numerous improvements in form of bug fixes and performance enhancements that are anyway addressed also with 2.13. So let's start with the features, important features on 2.13. First one on the list here is the command line interface. So command line interface as a functionality has been available in PCM600 for a while. Now with PCM600 2.13, a few more capabilities are introduced. Example, read-write support, project backup, validate and import parameters. So command line interface as such is quite a useful functionality wherein the commands can then be listed in a batch file and then can be executed. Another feature, important feature now introduced with 2.13 is the support for bulk configuration migration. So at times there are multiple relays within a PCM600 project whose configuration is to be migrated. So far this could be done per ID at a time. So it means it required frequent intervention. Now with bulk configuration migration, intermediate intervention is not required anymore. Trigger bulk migration, and PCM600 will handle the configuration migration of all the selected and supported relay. What's important to note is that this bulk configuration migration is a bit time intensive process. So it will take its own time before the whole configuration is migrated for all the selected relay, even though single ID configuration migration is still supported. So that was about important functionalities that were introduced with 2.13. Let us now have a quick look or a recap on certain important functionalities that were introduced with the previous PCM600 version, PCM600 2.12. So the high speed transfer functionality, that function that was introduced with the recent PCL update on REX64, and it's available via the application packages or apps 51, 52 and 53. So support to configure high speed transfer device or the HSTD, it's provided in the graphical display editor, and the state of the new HSTD function is shown on in the REX640 WebHMI, LHMI or the SHMI, and more details, technical details are then available also on the REX640 manuals. Next, quite important functionality or improvement introduced with 2.12, available also in 2.13, is with regards to the support line functionality. So when a support line case is to be reported, there is often quite a lot of big back and forth when the information required by support organization and with the customer. So this leads to unnecessary time investment from everyone. From PCM600 2.12 onward, it is possible to easily collect and share PCM600 related information with support line. Important to note here is that no user information is collected. The functionality as such is available also via command line interface. Now, this becomes really useful when, for example, PCM600 itself refuses to launch. So, just use command line interface and collect the information for the support line. Another improvement is in the parameter setting tool. A new filter is introduced where the non-default param values can be seen for a parameter. So, it is now possible to compare changed and saved parameters with the default value. So, it is available as a new item in the filter box or the filter list in the parameter setting tool. Another important functionality from PCM600 2.12 onwards, there is a change in the extension of backup files created by PCM600. So, an additional alphabet A is appended to the backup files, example APCMI, APCMA, APCMT. So, the backups are then appended with this extra A. However, the backups created with the previous PCM600 versions are still supported. So, that was very quickly about important functionalities and features that are brought up with PCM600 2.13 and recap of some important functionalities with PCM600 2.12. Feel free to reach out for questions and suggestions and queries. Also, you can learn more about our products by visiting go.abb/digitalsubstations. Thank you.